president says, I am the decider. Not on this issue. Not when it comes to attacking a country that has not attacked us and is not about to attack us. The Constitution could not be more unequivocal on that point. In Article 1, Section 8 of the Constitution, that is a decision for Congress. And the reason for that was that our founders very wisely did not trust any one man in power or woman, any king or queen, to make that decision, to have that power, and they meant to deny that to any one man in the American system. Now, granted, presidents have been acting like kings ever since Harry Truman went into Korea without congressional authorization. But certainly this president thinks he is a king. If he's allowed to lie Congress into supporting an attack on Iran, or if he goes ahead under any pretext without congressional authorization, then we, the public, both parties, the media, all of our institutions, are complicit in the overturning of our Constitution and a return to what amounts to monarchy or authoritarian government, dictatorship, tyranny, fascism, if you like, an elected king or almost elected king. It is not for him to decide that issue. It must be decided by a debate in Congress and the public, and decision by Congress, informed by better information on the costs and the risks and the dangers than was ever available in the case of Iraq or Vietnam. The only way that that information can come out is by unauthorized disclosure, that is, by leak. And what we've seen so far is that anonymous oral leaks to Cy Hirsch or to Time have not been enough even to arouse a major debate, let alone to really avert war. So the people who know that these plans are in operation, are moving ahead, know the president's determination and know that it would be disastrous, should consider at whatever cost to themselves, and the cost may well be very considerable personally, could even mean prison. They should consider making a personal sacrifice in order to uphold their own oath to the Constitution, to uphold the Constitution, to avert a disastrous war. They should go beyond oral anonymous leaks that don't risk their jobs to Cy Hirsch or to Time magazine. These very same people who have informed Time magazine of these plans should come out with the internal debate, the controversy, the costs and the estimates of which they are aware and have possession, and stand behind those estimates and their own action. Take responsibility for authenticating the documents, and documents are essential, for testifying to Congress, for campaigning, for showing the courage of their conviction. That's a phrase just came out of my mouth. Of course, what I'm really asking for is something a little different. Show the conviction behind their leaks. They should take responsibility for them in a way that demonstrates that they are serious when they say this is a catastrophic course of action. This is a time that calls for people to act as if there's no tomorrow politically, because in terms of democracy, that's where we are.